Heartland selects Sam Bowie, University of Kentucky. Sam Bowie, the young man who came back from a stress fracture injury to left shin bone. He was out for two seasons, redshirted, and he has come back. He has returned strong with Kentucky, and he's now the second pick in the draft. So I think we got an indication that Bowie was definitely going to Portland when he came in here carrying a Portland Trailblazer jacket.
That's right, a Portland Trailblazer jacket. I hope you guys could hear that audio clip. That was from 1984. That's right, 1984. And that was the sound audio from the NBA draft. And the gentleman's grave that I'm standing in front of today, Mr. Stuart Kirk Ingman, is part of the Blazers legacy here in Portland, which is our home team for the NBA. But Stuart Kirk Ingman is also betterly known for maybe making the most outrageous mistake in NBA history by selecting Mr. Sam Bowie, a center, over third pick in the 84 draft, Michael Jordan. That's right, Air Jordan himself was and could have gone to the Portland Trailblazers. Now, Stuart Kirk Ingman is known for this kind of NBA history mistake, if you will, but at the time, Portland Trailblazers did not need a center. They had a tremendous center at the time, and we also had a point guard by the name of Jim Paxson, who was putting up tremendous points per game. So at the time in 84, we were in need of a center. So during the draft, we lost first round pick to the Houston Rockets, who picked Hakeem Olajuwon. And we went with Sam Bowie because at the time, Mr. Kirk Ingman did his due diligence and realized that that's what Portland was lacking most. Was kind of a big man in the paint. And he had beautiful history with Portland in the past, being one of the GMs who would select players not only in past instances, but more importantly for the only winning championship team here in 77, which included Big Red, who is better known as Bill Walton, Maurice Cheeks, and a handful of other guys that were amazing players that went on to win Portland Trailblazers' one and only championship in 77. So Stuart was the man behind that team, and unfortunately he's better known as the guy that chose Sam Bowie over Michael Jordan. But in all, back then, Michael wasn't putting up the points that he did when he finally got selected to the Chicago Bulls and went on to win six championships with them in the finals at one point over Clyde, Terry, Porter, Jerome Kersey, Kevin Duckworth, Rick Adelman, Danny Ainge, just to name a few of the players that brought us the finals Western Conference. But we've never been back since, so I definitely want to pay my respects and honors to a guy here that not only paved the way for the Blazers in general, but opened up a lot of talk and controversy and things through the years by selecting Bowie over Jordan. And not that many people knew who that man was, but he actually lays to rest here at Willamette National Cemetery in Portland, Oregon. Now, Mr. Ingman died in 2007 at age 80 from cancer, but went on to actually coach at a high school out here in Lake Oswego. So he definitely did a lot in his time, not only for the Blazers, but his community here in Portland. So I wanted to creep up here today and take you guys to his final resting place to not only pay my respects, but to show you guys the connection to Portland. The Blazers are actually in the playoffs this season. We actually just, as of April 11th, 2019, we are going into the first round starting Sunday. So we definitely got Rip City back in full effect, and it totally just reminds me of the good old days when so many people here in Portland supported the Trailblazers and Rip City and all in all. And Stuart Kirk Ingman will definitely always be remembered here in Portland as somebody that did so much for not only the Blazers organization, but was the man who chose Sam Bowie over Michael Jordan. And unfortunately, there's been a lot of hearsay and talks throughout the years that it wasn't the best choice. But in all, I think everything happens for a reason. And like I said at the time, Michael Jordan wasn't putting up the numbers like he was when he went to the NBA. So Air Jordan wasn't really Air Jordan until he was drafted into the NBA, even though he was impressive in college. Mr. Inman had a great success in finding valuable players and created, like I said, pretty much our one and only team. So that's how I'd like to remember him, as actually bringing Portland one of their very first championships. A lot of people know that story, don't know that story as well as the draft pick kind of error, if you will. But in all, things happen for a reason, and I just believe that everybody and everything works out eventually in the long run. And so I love you guys so much for joining me. And like I said, I come up here to not only pay respects to this gentleman, but the Blazers organization all in all. I'm definitely a full-hearted Blazers fan. We have a saying out here in Portland called Rip City, which was one of our announcer's famous catchphrases by the name of Bill Shonley. And so that's always been big here in Portland. So I definitely thank you guys so much for joining me today. And I don't know if you guys could hear on the umbrella, but it is cold, wet here today. So I appreciate you guys tuning in as always. I'm even rocking my Blazers hat for the playoffs. And I'm hoping that we're going to get far this season. So I appreciate you guys coming up here with me today, and I hope you guys enjoyed this as much as I did bringing it to you. And I hope you guys do one better and hit that like button. You can even hit that little bell icon, that way when I creep, you guys will be the first to know. With that being said, I love you guys. Oh, don't forget to maybe send over a new creeper to the channel. Get yourself entered into the 900th creeper t-shirt giveaway. And that should be very soon. So I'm excited for that. Go Blazers, Rip City. I love you guys. Thanks for tuning in. Creeper out for now. Peace.